I'm sorry. What's up, guys? It's me, Brendan, with part two of a series I really need to be coming out with a lot faster. I just wanted to say a couple of things. I really haven't found time to record recently, and I've been having some issues with OneDrive, mainly that I haven't wanted to upload one big part of this video to it because I'm lazy, and my school schedule is pretty rigorous. So I'm so sorry that this took so long to come out, so sorry. Anyways, back on track. I've realized a few things since last episode that I should touch on. During this run, I began to fear one type of spirit in particular, being Kapora Gabora and others like him, in which controls get reversed and unreversed after a while. I'm wondering if I should go for them or not, but I'm sticking with an any percent run at this point, so as of now I'll only fight them if I absolutely am required to. So, after the painful boss battle and the very satisfying death cutscene thereafter, I forgot I was going towards Galleom for a moment and started heading towards Yoshi. To get him, however, I had to make it through our next obstacle, Yarn Yoshi. It's another horde battle, except this time, the Yoshis actually know how to work together. With the added fact that they are small, hard to hit, and very strong, along with the increased knockback aspect, I had a very hard time fighting the spirit. Eventually, however, I found a strategy that worked. I used Mario, and luring them up towards the top platform, spammed up B, which, as I explained in part 1, causes way too much knockback than is healthy. Seriously, one hit from up B will kill each Yoshi. After I fought through all the other spirits and acquired Yoshi, I remembered my real goal, defeating Galleom. Thus, I ran very, very far to face the next spirit in my path. Along the route you are about to witness, I got Olimar, Mega Man, and somebody else. Can't remember who though. The other two real pains I encountered came in the forms of Roll Casket and Master Belch. Belch's sticky floors are annoying, and Wario is also annoying, so have fun, I guess. Roll Casket, however, was a different story. You had to defeat a tiny Diddy Kong and an Isabelle with Hakatate bombs appearing everywhere. Chances are that you will only be able to grab about a half of them, even with Villager's Pocket, but grab as many as you can and use them all immediately. This is the only strategy I have found that works, and it's not even very reliable. Inside the base, nothing difficult is encountered. Just make sure to press this button on the second power generator thingy, and you are good to go. I, however, wanted to grab Snake, as I hinted at last episode, but I could not for the life of me get past this fight. The Robs just attacked too quickly, and they collaborated in taking me down. If anyone out there has any skill at not turning around, please try this one out. Then there was the Dr. Wily fight.
No!
After our humiliating failure at the hands of two giant metal robots, we fight against Galleom. This two-ton brute is a cyborg with no mercy, and will stop at nothing to kill us where we stand. He's a mean, not very lean, purple fighting machine, literally, and he's super easy. This guy took me about 30 minutes, tops, in one play session. No trouble at all out of this guy. The only pointers I can give are to master the art of the spot dodge and to look out for a grab or a punch when you maneuver behind him. It comes out faster than you would think. Yeah, that's all I've got for this episode. I'll try to get the next one out as soon as possible, which will probably be in a few weeks, so don't get your hopes up. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.